All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen.
We are doing a few different things today. We've got those sun-dried tomatoes we're making in the oven, so now we're doing a different show. We are gonna do Sicilian Caponata. Caponata is sort of like an appetizer that you would eat with bread. And what we're gonna do is we've got eggplant that Nonna Pina is gonna cut up and cut into thin strips. We're gonna cut up some onion. We add some olives, black olives, oregano, salt, pepper, capers is another ingredient here, the capers. That bottle is actually some white vinegar and olive oil. What Nonna Pina is gonna do is she's gonna slice the eggplant, and we're gonna show you that, with the onion, combine it with all these ingredients and cook it on the stovetop. Right, Nonna Pina? You're gonna cook it on the stovetop over there.
Fry.
Yeah, you're gonna fry it up and then you're gonna jar it.
Yeah, after
they
put it in a jar.
And that could stay how long in the jar?
Hey, 1 year, 2 years, depends.
Beautiful. And you eat it with bread, you serve it as an appetizer?
Yeah.
Con un primo piatto?
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is Sicilian Caponata. I'm actually excited. Thank you, Nonna Pina. Let's do it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have cut the eggplant into cubes, as you can see. We fried them to about 95%. Let me see how soft these are. Let's see here. Yeah, so there's a bit of resistance when you squeeze them. You don't want them fully cooked. No, non sono cotte tutte, right?
No.
I'd say about 90, 95% cooked. Okay. Then we fried onions and you added some tomato paste. And now, Nonna Pina, we've got the olives, the capers. We did not mention the sugar in the beginning, but I did mention that we were going to add sugar and the tomato paste. So, Nonna Pina, what are you going to do here? Let's see what you got.
Now?
Yeah, go ahead, Ma. Okay, so this you put to taste, as much as you want, people. If you don't like black olives, I mean, don't put them in, but it's part of the ingredients. As well with capers. Capers are a very unique type of taste. So if you've never tasted a caper, I would taste it before you add it to this caponata. But it does add a very unique signature flavor of the traditional caponata. Okay, oregano. Okay, a couple of pinches of oregano. This is all to taste. More olives, less olives. One caper, 20 capers, all up to you. Some black pepper. Okay.
Sugar.
Okay, how much sugar are you going to put, Ma?
Two spoons.
2 spoons of sugar? Well, this is a kid, no? Three melanzane, I don't know.
What?
So these are 4 eggplants, but she's putting 2 tablespoons of sugar. So, common sense, the more sugar you put, the sweeter it's going to be. What else are you going to put on the pina?
A little bit of salt.
And some salt. And you put pepper already. Okay. So now what? What do we do now?
Now a little bit of vinegar.
Vinegar, okay. Vinegar. Just a touch of vinegar, eh? Go ahead, Ma.
Wait a minute.
Okay, so you got sweet, you got savory, you've got the vinegar, so 2 tablespoons of vinegar, 3 tablespoons of vinegar?
Okay.
Okay, so 3 tablespoons of vinegar. So sweet, salty, vinegar is sour, The capers are a mixture of spicy and sour, and the sweetness of the tomatoes and the onion, the tomato paste and the onion. So you mix this all?
Yeah.
And then, Nonna Pina, you serve this on a piece of toast or a nice piece of Italian panino, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Mischia le trussai, ma benzo. Mischia le trussai. Mischia, mischia. Okay. And then what are you going to do, Nonna Pina? You're going to jar it.
Yeah.
So let me get you a jar, okay? Yeah, I think there's a jar there.
Yeah.
Okay. There you go. Yeah, I don't know if you want to taste. Taste it for salt, taste it for sweetness, your own preference. How is it, Nonna Pina?
A little bit of salt.
Okay, you need more salt. So the reason that Nonna Pina didn't cook it to 100% the eggplant is because the vinegar and the sugar and the jarring process is going to slowly break down that last 10% of that eggplant and its cooking process. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Does this have to stay in the fridge, or does it, can it go in the cold cellar?
In the fridge.
Okay, so it doesn't have to be in a fridge, but once you open it, like to eat, when this jar gets unsealed, you would want to keep it in the fridge at that point. Ooh.
Sure.
It's okay now. You want to press it in there? Nice and tight. And just finish off with just a bit of the oil. Okay, Nonna Pina, now what? You're gonna seal it. Okay, Giudolo. Hold it high, Ma. Let's see how that jar looks. Ma, let me see the jar. Yeah, let's see, Ma. Hold it tight, don't move. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Sicilian Caponata, made here at Nonna Pina's Sicilian Cucina. Nonna Pina, say bye to the lovely people.
Bye, everybody.
All right, smile, Ma. Okay, wonderful. Thank you.